up, everybody? Welcome to day 307, making Songbringer. And today I'm going to be working on this cutscene some more. Just checking out these frames, stream. Make sure everything's cool here. Yeah, so let me show you what... let's kill that. Here's the... Where is it at? Oh, I got rid of it because I tried to load it. I'm working on these two different branches. I got a master branch and a fun branch. And whenever I check out the master branch, I lose my fun stuff for a second. What's up, Pedro? At least it's not in my working file index. So, understanding Git more and more. How you doing, Pedro? How's the second game going? February game. What's up, Pizza? Pima? Forever first. Forever first. So here is the image from yesterday. Somewhat finished. What's up, Salad Dongs? I think the hand still needs a lot of work. It's like not thick enough. It's looking kind of weird to me. And I need to do some kind of background or something like that. But today I want to work on the actual scene part of it. So I'm gonna get it out into the game. So it, right, I need to just determine how much of this screen is visible, right? It's gonna be kind of like letterbox like this during this cutscene. So basically just doing the code for this cutscene and getting it to mechanically work how I want it to. And then I can go and make the art super awesome in the end. You already have spawning enemies and weapon effects? Cool. The connection's better today? That's awesome. Oh, man. Yesterday was really pooping me out with that all. I mean, it's still dropping a couple frames. But yeah, it's not doing its flickering. It used to, like, this happens, like, whenever the stream gets bad on my end and it can't upload enough, it starts blinking here. All right, good. Good, good, good. What's up, Arcane and Chaotic? He's your partner in crime? Oh, what's up? Cool, man. His name is also Pedro? What's up, Pedro's? Yeah, thanks, man. I mean, this isn't the final image. This is still work in progress. But let's get it exported and put it in the game. And I'm gonna start making a scene out of this. Oh, this is gonna go in raw scenes. I guess, yeah, I'll put it in its own sprite sheet. Okay, so let's get that maxed. All right, so what I'm gonna do is add another sprite sheet for the scene sword. Digging the stream, sweet man. Cheers, dude. Okay, so get rid of these. And then add this sword into its own scene. Let's call this scene sword. Save that. Okay, so now when I build the project, you should rebuild the textures and go verify that that's running. Yeah, it looks like it did. Build Mac. It processed all the sprite sheets and went, oh, I'm gonna reprocess the sword scene here. And should have a new, yeah, okay, so now we have a new asset called Scene Sword. All right, great, now we're hooked up. We can go, now I'm gonna need to create a new kind of flux type. So this is gonna be a new thing. because I've never done a flux exactly like this one before. I've done this one called Evil Awakening, which is kind of the same thing as a cutscene, but I'm going to make a more generic cutscene flux. This is a specific cutscene flux. And then in flux, where's the Pink Panther? Oh, we were doing the Pink Panther, yeah, but when I started drawing the pink, when I started that, that was a different one won, right? Whatever the other one won it, and then later I looked back again, and Pink Panther had suddenly pulled ahead somehow. So I don't know. I'm not gonna do that just yet. Transition. Okay, so there's this thing called set item, but we actually want to set. I guess we could set it. Nah, it's kind of cheesy to set it based on it. Yeah, we want to go set. This kind of sucks that we have to do it this way, but set. We could either call it parameter one or flux string. Either way. Okay. So in flux, when it starts everything off, it's going to have not only like a flux item, but this is another kind of parameter, right? Static string, flux string. Whoops. Yeah. So we can also have, instead of calling this, we can call flux set string. So now we can pass in a parameter when we're starting this flux. Flux string equals stir. So right, so we're gonna call this the flux cutscene, and we're gonna pass in a string first. So when does it do this? Oh, we're going to need to create a whole new type of thing. Oh, maths assessment? Oh, what? Is that kind of like, what kind of assessment is that? But, so this, we're going to be calling this cutscene right in the middle of picking up the sword. Wow, which means we're gonna have to break it up into two. Quaternions. Okay, before I go and split this whole flux into two different types, I'm just going to run a cutscene at the very beginning. Of Lift Sword. Yeah. So I didn't even really need that string parameter yet, but okay, so Lift Sword's going to go walk to and then K phase cutscene. So we need a cutscene phase now. What's up, Mighty Ness? A block test. They have to move some people around math sets. Oh. Free parking, Neutermelt. What's up, PMC? Welcome, 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 welcome. I'm working on this this scene where it's gonna be a cutscene where it displays part of this image and it'll like zoom in. So like it'll start here and go and zoom up on the whole sword while you're lifting the sword at the very beginning. So I'm incorporating a new type of phase to the flux transitions, which will be called cutscene, which I'm going to use eventually to do kind of like generic cutscenes. Any kind of cutscene, you can pass in a string and tell it what cutscene to play, and then it'll run that cutscene. So actually, we do need to do a phase cutscene. So flux, if we were doing its own kind of flux, it would be cave phase cutscene. And I guess zoom in, zoom out might be a good thing to put on here too. Yeah, we'll leave these. I don't know yet. But for now, I'm just putting it in the middle of lift sword, so I'm going to make that obvious. Yeah, no, it's going to get even cooler. So the cutscene already, you know, it's got a good sound, it's got a good music, and, you know, a good little animation and stuff. But this is going to be even better, where there's a long time while the character is holding the sword in the air, so there's plenty of time to do something like this, where it displays a little bit of zoom in on the sword. All right, pizza. See you, man. Okay, so now we need to be able to do the phase cutscene. I'm copying Evil Awakening to start with, because it's very similar. Okay, I could keep it all just as it is for the moment. And then there's one other place I've got to add this new phase, which is right here, hooking up the actual phase to the list of phases that are possible in the flux. So K phase cutscene. That should be all the occurrences of phase Evil Awakening we can find. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so we got phase Evil Awakening, we got phase cutscene. Now in phase cutscene, let's make it, instead of playing the Evil Awakening thing, we'll play the whatever string it is that we have. So here we'll set the string if there's no video again. Oh my god. Really? Sorry guys, I've been so focused on fixing bugs in the game and developing new stuff that I haven't called Comcast yet. Once again, looks like there might be a black screen today, but I'm just going to keep streaming anyways, and you guys will be able to view this on YouTube later, and you can listen along if you want and perhaps occasionally catch a glimpse. My apologies. What's up, Lighter Thief? Sorry, it might be black screen. So flux string is empty. Just gonna manually set this one. This is gonna be intro sword. Okay, now we need to hook that up too. So I'm gonna touch projects, data. What are these called again? It's not entities, is it? It is, I put it in entities. Yeah, okay, so flux, projects, data, entities. This isn't really an entity. Oh well. Call this one intro sword. And I'll open up both those. Evil. And intro sword. Okay, so the format for this animation is just intro sword in the sprite sheet. Intro sword P list, which we confirmed a minute ago, but let me just make sure. Yeah. Textures scene. Oh, it's scene sword. Lips. Okay, let's untouch. Projects, data, entities, move intro sword to scene sword. And then also this flux string should by default be scene sword. Yeah, sorry about the black screen, guys. Yeah, no, it's gonna go in and out like yesterday, probably, with the stream. So, yeah, for I mean, all I can do at this point, I haven't called Comcast because I've been in you know, I've been working on the game. So, I gotta make some priority time and just call Comcast. I know it's gonna be like a half an hour event to get them on the phone and figure it all out, but I don't know. I'll get to it. For now, I guess I'm just gonna stream like this, where it's gonna go in and out and. You can watch it on YouTube later if you want. The chat isn't black. That's right, PFC. Yeah. This is the podcast version. This is a podcast version of Making Songbringer. Right now I got scene sword. One more thing. What did I call this? Just sword? Oh, yeah, it's just sword. That should not be called just sword. Yeah, let's actually call that scene sword zero. There we go. Okay, so we should have, that should have touched our. Touch the pack, the textures, so they rebuilt. Yes, it did call rebuild, fail to load. Oops. Okay, texture packer, reopen, recent, scene sword. So didn't like that, scene sword zero. There we go. So since that has now been updated, it should automatically repack again. Yeah, good. That time it packed right. No video with audio is better than nothing at all. Right on. Because it's inspiring? Right on, Salad Dongs. That's awesome. I hope it's inspiring. I hope it, you know, I hope I can help you guys too. Like, whatever. Or at least encourage you, you know? You calling for me? Credit card, anything valuable? Got you, dude. Yeah. I'll email you all that stuff right off the stream. You probably want, like, my mother's maiden name and my social security number and stuff like that, too, right? It's safe to give that across the internet, right? I can just put all that into Google and it's like, totally good. Okay, so let's make sure this is all gonna run the right stuff. Oh, I'm gonna set this up. So when we're running a cutscene, I don't wanna set the heroes to be invisible. Flux duration is going to be based on the animation that we're running. So we're going to need to create like a cutscene sprite here. This is where we're getting that animation for the idle. Yeah. And then this is also where we're going to set the flux duration. Anim get duration. Yeah, so as it runs this animation, let's give it a long delay so it can go like 5 seconds of showing this sword. Once again, we don't need to hide the heroes. Now we can run the cutscene sprite. JMonkey Engine, what's that? This creates the sprite given the first frame of the idle, puts on the layer. I got a better Z than that. Render system. Oh, render component. Get Z order. Given KZ high. So it goes run action, delay time, and then animate. That's because it fades in. I guess that works. We're gonna do something cooler than this. This will be a cool like animation that brings it in and stuff. We don't want to do any particles. Don't need to delete old entities. That has nothing to do with this. Threshold. Don't think we have anything to do with these threshold stuff either. Fade layer. All right, this removes the sprite, removes the texture, makes all the heroes visible again. Okay, this is ready to run for the first time. We'll see how this goes. Oh, we gotta put the player where he's gonna pick up the sword and take away the current sword. So let's do sword. Let's say haven't fought the sword boss. We're at the point where we're gonna pick up the sword. And that's it. Right, so we've got the sword sitting there. What's going to happen here is it should walk to the sword and then run the cutscene and then pick up the sword. Even though these are going to be out of order, and what I really want to eventually happen is that you'll pick up the sword, lift it into the air, wait a second, then do the cutscene, then cut back into the second half of the lifting sword phase where he puts this like holds it for another second, puts it back down. But for now, it's gonna be out of order. All right, nice. It worked. It worked. What's up, Black Iron? The video's working all of a sudden. Sweet. That's awesome. Okay, so that worked. That worked with the cutscene. Great, 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 great. The next thing I want this cutscene to do is to like move upward, and then after that I'll make it so it does some kind of fade and then some kind of letterboxing to make it look like a cutscene. Yeah. Okay, so let's do First, I'll do. Yeah, first I'll do the movement. All right, so we're going to go move by. This is going to be different for each one of these cutscenes, but for now, we've got flux duration. And we're going to do movement is whatever the size of this sprite is. So vec2 movement. Yeah, so this is going to be sprite get content size. Let's just get that first. It gives you a DOS game vibe. Sweet. Oh, that's so cool. I'm so glad it gives a DOS game vibe. And nice. Whoa, Pedro, cool. That's cool. Dude, that's so nice of Boogie to share Bot Fu with you. I wonder what Boogie's eventually going to do with Bot Fu. Bot Fu is really cool. It'd be nice to see it kind of like benefit other people's streams too somehow. Heck, I mean, Boogie could even profit from that. You know, it'd be a cool service or something like that. It's almost like gamifying your stream. Uh-oh, this is sprite. Get content size. So the movement of this is, we're setting it 0. So this is going to be sprite. Get content, oops. Just size. Size dot width. No. Yeah, size dot width minus k design res x. And then this is gonna be size dot height minus k design res y. So if it's a really tall image, like it's like twice the size of the screen, then its movement is gonna be like half the screen. So yeah, so it's going to flux duration for this move. Just go movement. Let's see if that works now. Oh, it's saved already. That's right. I forgot that this flux saves itself halfway through. All right, so take away the sword. It's funny how it scrolled off the screen. So it moved exactly the wrong way. Supposed to be negative movement, or why is that? If your size the height, say like 480, your design res is 240, that's 240 pixels. Oh, yeah, it's because you're moving the bottom left corner down. Yeah, all right, so this is K design res Y minus size dot height. This is K design res X minus size dot width. And it's not using this fade layer, so I can probably get rid of that and the delay before. Let's do that right now. So take off the fade layer and the delay time that it does for the fade layer. Alright, picking up the sword. It like immediately runs its animation. Look at them flames. Cool. It's working. So the next thing will be to get rid of the flames and make a cooler intro for this so it like shows the cutscene cooler. But I'll be right back. Gotta get a drink of water. Be right back with the black screen and the podcast version. Party. Oh, first, yeah, let's get rid of this. This is Z-High 1. Let's do Z-High 7999. That'll put it, I should put it above the flames. And then we'll do a cooler, like, intro for this. How would thinking kind of like the, how the item menu comes in with this sweet like effect. It'll be kind of like that for cutscenes. Alright, it didn't quite show the whole image. I think it's probably because I'm using design res where I should be using the frame buffer size. So let me give it the frame buffer size and give it another try. Get frame buffer size. A little bit more smoothness? Yeah, that for sure too. There'll be more smoothness, a cooler effect at the end. Yeah. So Ziri, I'm working on this whole effect right now. I just started it, and yeah, there's gonna be a whole different intro and outro to this cutscene. So when it starts the cutscene, it's gonna do some kind of animation or something like that, bringing in the window, and then as it finishes the cutscene, it will also do another animation of it going out or something, and then also it's gonna fit inside of the other lift sword phase, in the middle of it. Right now it's right at the beginning just because I'm in test mode. But in a moment I'll have it so it's actually in the middle. So everything will become smooth. All right, let's see if it shows the entire sword this time. And Ziri, welcome to the stream, man. How you doing? I didn't do it that time either. All right, let's see why. We'll set a breakpoint here, movement, so we can see what movement is being calculated as. Same with size and FP size. Where are you? What the hell's wrong with the window? Oh my God. Come on, debugger. It's like the debugger's in La La Land over here. University off for 4 weeks? Sweet. Right on, 4 week break. Sweet, you driving home? Cool. What university do you go to? What part of the world are you in? I'm here in California. I was gonna say sunny California, but thankfully we've been getting plenty of rain this year. Oh wow, Vienna, that's sweet. Did you get to go to the indie game fest or whatever? It just happened this last month in January in Vienna. Or maybe it wasn't Vienna. No, it wasn't Vienna. Sorry. Somewhere else. But there's one kind of, I think it's kind of close to you in Vienna, right? Isn't the one in, there's one in Independent, it's called Independent Games Fest. Where is that again? Independent Games Festival. Oh, I think it's Zurich. That's right. It's in Zurich, not Vienna. No, this isn't it either. No, this isn't it. It's not Independent Games Fest. There's one in Zurich. I forget what it's called. Oh well. Doesn't matter. Okay, once again. Set a breakpoint there. Yeah, it actually set a right breakpoint that time. Nice. Okay, the size of the sprite is 420 by 560. The frame buffer size is 420 by 263. So the entire movement of this thing as it goes upwards, I think it might actually need to be the entire movement and the entire size of this. Let's try this. Let's just try some things willy-nilly till everything works. Whoops. Okay, that was wrong. I guess that's just to be like this. Free parking for Zyinger. Yeah. You got raccooned. Free parking. You got 46 free points. Whoops. Yeah, that was too far. Okay, maybe it's supposed to be half the frame buffer size. Right? Because it already starts viewing half of it. I think this might be it. Whoop! It was? Yeah, so Bob Food is like giving out points now sometimes randomly. Because you got free parking. Just like, you know, Pasco. Free parking. Monopoly. Whoa! Alright, I don't like the width one. Let's just ignore the width for a moment. Let's see if the height is actually right. Oh wait, this should be at the zero total. Oh, whoops. Little things like this. Yeah, I know, right? Look at this cool sword. But it's not there anymore. Nope. I hate to do this because I don't understand, but let me try 3/4. The game's clearly finished. EA quote? Nice one. Was that actually right? Yeah, I think that was right. So if I go 1.0, should not get all the way to the top. Oh, I hate it when I don't understand something. Regardless though, I think the next thing here is to do the animation part of it all. So I can technically get this working even better later. It's going from C. Should be A. Wait. That did not even show the whole thing, did it? Right? This is the problem. I like it didn't even show half of it. It is pointing upwards. All right, whatever. I don't understand. I don't understand, but I'm just going to proceed anyways. So, yeah, I know, Ziri. I know it's still in the floor. Like I said, I'm doing half of the animation, or doing this first part of it before I get into it. So what I'm going to do eventually is I'm going to take there's three phases that are going on here. One is you run this cutscene. Two of the other ones are where the player picks up the sword and holds it in the air and then puts the sword back down. That's three different phases. Right now, It's one phase where he lifts the sword, holds it in the air, and then puts it back down. So I need to split it up into different phases. So until I do that, I'm just working on the cutscene phase part of it all first. So that's why it's not the right timing. It's not the right sequence. The sequence is off. Because I'm in the flux of code right now. Yeah, so I want this to like do a cool animation on the intro to the cutscene. I'm thinking kind of like the item phase when it brings down the window. Yeah, this is all there is to it. It's just set the scale really weird. So I'll do a similar weirdness, see how this works. So it sets the scale really big on the X, really small on the Y, and it does this ease exponential to scale it in. So let's see how that looks. What's up, Mark Consu? I'm using 3.9 Cocos 2DX. I'm using the new version of Rapid Game. And I'm using a custom version of 3.9 Cocos 2DX. I disable a bunch of things that I don't need, like the JavaScripting engine. Oh, that was weird. Oh. It needs to be anchored in the middle. First of all, Vec2. Alright, this is going to change everything, but it's okay. Let's get the frame buffer size, the window size. Director, get instance, get win size. And okay, so we're gonna put the player right in the, or this image right in the middle of the window. So we'll go vec2 win size times 0.5. And then the anchor is gonna be in the middle, so anchor middle. And hopefully this means I can just do the movement is only half the frame buffer size height. I don't know. Hopefully that's right. And then that should allow this to work too. So it does like an animation when it's bringing in this in. I actually think it might need to be zero now. And I want to scale it only to, let's just do 0.75 for a moment so you can get the feeling that this is letterboxed, even though it's just going to look weird because its pixels will be off now. But I want it because I'm thinking this will eventually be a letterboxed, like, cutscene that's scrolling by. So let's see what it looks like with letterboxing. Oh, maybe this needs to be a hole. And it didn't letterbox, did it? Oh, that would explain a lot. Oh no. I think that's what it is. That's why it's acting so weird. Yeah. So I've got it at 0.75 scale. And it's only viewing half of it. Either that or this is not being applied at all. That could be. I can't see why it would be. Yeah, so for anybody who just joined the stream or you're watching on YouTube or whatever, I'm working on a cutscene here, and I'll see there. Now it's the right width. That's really confusing. Why would it need to do half the scale? Here, what if I leave that alone? The sprite scale is going to be 1.0 to start. All it does is animate and move. There's no other scale application going on. Yeah, it's too zoomed in. Somebody tell me why. Why? Oh, maybe it scaled it up? Oh, hold on a second. Scene sword of plist. Frame scene sword 0. It's 420 by 560. It's fine. 420 pixels tall. It's not scaled or anything, is it? So video went out again. Hopefully it'll come back. We'll see. Gonna open up Texture Packer one more time and double check that there's nothing going on that would cause it to scale bigger, but even though it doesn't look like it is, max size, scaling variance, scale 1. There's no other variance. Okay. Show advanced on layout. Yeah, it's just scale 1. Okay, there's nothing wrong with that. So, okay, I can safely assume that the image, the texture that's loading, is the right size. It's somehow, though, coming out to be twice as big as the screen. Maybe it needs to be sprite set camera mask to K default camera flag. It could be drawing it. Oh, that's what it is. Okay. There's two cameras. I always forget about this. There's two cameras in this game. One is the interior camera inside the frame buffer. One is the exterior camera outside the frame buffer. One is primarily used for in-game effects and in-game entities and sprites. The other is used for the HUD and for things like that. This cutscene right here is meant for the HUD, so this is a proper way to do it. And so what was happening there was it was zooming in like twice as big. All the pixels were zoomed in. And then the new scene, the sword cutscene, was being applied inside the camera, to the inside camera, basically. So that's why it was twice as big. Yeah, sorry, number one Talon. And that time it didn't even draw. Might have something to do with its Z order. Oh wait, no, it's probably its layer. Yeah, this needs to be seen now. And then doesn't need to be this such a high Z anymore. But I'll keep it really high for a second. Wait. What is this random breakpoint here? Okay, if this works now, it will be the right size, and I will be a lot less confused. Yeah! It's the right size. And that does mean that the frame buffer size times half is what we want to move it by. Actually, it's wind size to height. Yeah, which is basically the pause. Let's see if that works, then I can use pause, save pause, and then subtract pause there. Problem was it didn't start at the right height. The sprite is being attached anchor middle. Oh, this shouldn't be wind size times a half. This should be frame buffer size. Is that right? Frame buffer size? No. No, it should definitely be. Oh, it's not anchor middle. Yeah, we do not want anchor middle. We want anchor middle in the X, but zero on the Y. And then positioned in the middle of the screen. No. Positioned in the middle of the screen on the X. Oh, yeah, because it's tall. Okay, I'm going to set a manual position, and it's yeah, sorry, it's a black screen today, guys. My internet connection's been horrible the last few days. So yeah, if you want to catch this video on YouTube, it'll be on YouTube later. It's on my to-do list to call Comcast, figure out why I've been having incredibly slow upload rates, even though I already called them and got a new box and everything. They probably needed to come out to my house and check it out. So this is the podcast version. This is the podcast version of Songbringer development. So we're going to set pause. All right. So it's the position of the sprite. This sprite is. I think frame buffer size and wind size are going to be about the same thing. That might be the case. Anyways, I think it's going to be FB size dot width times a half and FB size dot height times a half. No, no, no. It's epi-size dot height. This is frame buffer offset. Oh yeah, all right. I knew I computed this somewhere already. Get frame buffer offset. So this position. Yeah, this is frame buffer offset. Yeah, podcast mode, sorry. What's up, State Off Games? How you doing today? So that'll offset it, put it at zero. And then it needs to scroll. For a whole... the size of the whole image minus the design res. I think it's design res. Jeez, why does regular math always take me so long? It's because things are confusing. You have so many layers in the games, you know? You got your game layer, your in-game layer, your super duper in-game layer, your scale on each one of the nodes inside all those layers. Things can get really complex fast, even though started at the bottom, scrolling up to the top. Oh, it went too far, barely too far. Oh, that's because it did do the right thing. It went the entire frame buffer size. So we need to do some kind of letterboxing at this point. Nice, Saladoms. So yeah, if you're just joining the stream, it may go in and out, right? Sometimes my internet gets a little wind in its sails and all of a sudden you can see it. Oh, you're moving, huh? Oh. Yeah, at least you guys see a little bit of it. And maybe it'll come back in right when I'm finished. And then I'll be like, oh, look, it's finished. So what I'm doing now is I'm adding two black sprites to the bottom and the top so that it letterboxes. While it does these cutscenes only, it's going to do a little bit of letterboxing. It's going to fade in really cool, too. Kind of like, what's the Zelda 64 one? You know, Ocarina of Time or whatever. All right, so we're going to have a bottom sprite. So we have two letterbox sprites. Letterbox I. Wait, this is let's do this better. Auto ref S, which is standing for sprite, equals kit sprite. Pixel.ping, parent, game scene, z, 10,000. So each one of these is going to have a width, set scale. So the width is going to be the frame buffer size. I think it's just win size. Win size that width. Float scale y. This is where it's going to be the frame buffer offset. No. Okay, I'm going to do a const float letter box height. That's going to be k design res y minus 16. So if my total height is 240 normally, it's going to be like 224, which would be very Zelda-esque. I think Zelda was 224 pixels tall. Okay, so set scale, win size dot width. All right, this is going to be win size dot height. No. Have you checked this for fixing black screen? I don't use Open Broadcaster. Yeah, see, I'm already using X264 as well. So his solution was he switched his encoder from the NVEC NVIDIA encoder to X264. I'm already using X264 and all the recommended settings from Twitch. Yeah. Yeah, maybe I should right now. Oh, I already started this video. Yeah, maybe tomorrow. Okay, that's what I'll do, Pedro. If I haven't called Comcast by tomorrow, I'll try streaming with Open Broadcaster. Well, yeah, but I mean, it could be a capture problem. But why wasn't it a capture problem all of these months that I'm already been using it? You know, it's been perfectly fine. And then all of a sudden, why would it coincide perfectly with my internet's upload speed going down? So I used to have an upload speed of 15 megs a second. It was great. And then all of a sudden on a good day, I have 5, and now it's 4, like 4 to 3.5. Oh, there. So now I've got the scale set for these two. I'm creating two sprites to represent the letter boxing blackness on bottom and top. And I'm going to put these on top of everything else so that I can just draw the cutscene underneath them and it will look letterbox. And what's cool about this is I can fade the letterbox sprites in and out so they can have their own kind of animation. So I'm setting their opacity to start with to 0 and running an action. sequence. E's exponential in. I might do a sine wave actually. Let me think. Yeah, it seems to be sine. Sine's a little smoother. And this is going to be fade to create. And the fade, I'll do a fade duration const. Float fade duration equals. So let's say that it fades in these letterboxing sprites over maybe point 0.618. No, this is more like 0.2. It seems to be fast. So fade duration. It's fading from 0 to 255. So it's bringing in these black sprites. And then it delays, delay time, create. The delay is going to be fade, no, flux duration minus fade duration times 2. And then we run another fade out. So E sine in, in's fine. Fade to, once again, fade duration, but this time back to 0. And after we're done with that, we can go remove self. And that will clean up the sprite as well. So this is basically fading it in, letting it sit there for a while, fading it out, destroying itself. And then the last thing they need is to be set with their right positions. So s.setPosition and anchor points. So set anchor point back to 0, set position. Oh, it's every 30 minutes. Okay, I didn't know about that. Well, that's interesting because now I know every 30 minutes, I can kind of keep track of what 30 minutes is as far as how long, you know what I mean? I'd be like, oh, okay, I've seen free parking twice. The stream's been going for an hour. Vec2, this is gonna be either, it's gonna be 0 on the X always. It's either gonna be, oh, actually, this is easy enough if I just go. It's and the anchor point's gonna be 0 or I equals 0, 0, 1. I equals 0, 0, win size dot height. Doesn't like swing size. Oh, because I commented it out. Ooh. I'll give Bot Fu some points. I'm putting some points into Bot Fu. That works, right? Can I show Bot Fu's points? He did need those points. Oh, cool. Yeah, it shows his points. Now he's got 3,400 points. Yeah! All right, plenty of free parking available. All right, what do we got here? Let's see if this works. Least I've moved beyond the simple math problem. Well, no, not entirely beyond the simple math problems. Right, we do not have the two letterbox sprites. They should be on screen, invisible, running. I guess they also need to set color. Set color. Black. Still nothing. Oh. Figured it out. So this needs a set camera flag, of course. Set camera flag. Camera mask. K default camera flag. Yeah, kind of worked. Yeah, it's looking better a little bit. So, I want it to fade in the movement as well. So that should fade in the main cutscene sprite as well. There's one more thing. What was it? What was I thinking? Forgot. Oh, it needs to set its original opacity. That's right. Sprite set opacity 0. Nice. The only thing is I think it should go a little slower on the fade. Let's do 0.4 seconds there. And let's see what it looks like with this crazy fade-in, scale-in thing. Did weird scale because I forgot I had it one. Put it to one, I mean. Okay. Gosh, I'm so glad the math. I figured out that it was on the wrong camera. That was confusing me earlier. I'm like, why doesn't this basic math work? Because it's not basic math, it's a complex system. Many layers. Oh, okay, that time it did a weird scale in. Yeah, all right, let's take off the scale in. I just want to focus on the actual fade parts of it first. I like the fade in, but the fade out right now is not quite looking good. if this was double the fade duration? Both of these. So the actual image fades in slower and fades out slower. Nice try, I stayed up. Yeah, Bafu. Bafu's like, that's a null command. It worked. It looked good. The only problem was it didn't look good at the top. It didn't quite go all the way to the top. Or I mean, it went slightly too far. This might need to be frame buffer size. I'm having trouble telling if that actually worked or not. You're so smart. What's that? Besides that you're so smart, why is it so? What you doing? What you doing? Okay, my next instinct is to try this. Design res Y plus frame buffer offset dot Y minus size dot height. Sounds right. 1, 2, 3, test. Bafu welcomes you all. Maybe that's frame buffer offset Y times a half. Yeah, I'm totally guessing. Now we can send commands chat directly from Bafu. Cool. Nice, man. Maybe that needs to be minus. I'm just doing. Play the middle of this animation into the place this into the middle of the other phase. See, that didn't change anything, did it? Oh, because the frame buffer offset's gonna be zero, huh? Oh, I think I'm finally starting to understand. What I really need to do is to take off the black letterbox sprites momentarily. Oh hell, I'm not even using them. Not even saving them. And then, okay, so now that I've got that, I think it needs to set its position. Okay, let me set that. Let me set a freaking breakpoint so I understand. It's back with video? No way! It's back! Yep, yeah, so I'm already, what, an hour and a half into this, and all I've been doing is scrolling the image for one single image. We're trying to dial this in. And rip again. Well, it was a good 5 second run, right? Frame buffer, oh, see, the frame buffer offset's zero, no wonder. Really what I want is the frame buffer size. This is frame buffer size. Dot height. Minus K design res Y times a half. What's up, Jonah19? Sorry, man, we're in podcast mode again. Black screen day. Oh. Gotta get somebody from Comcast out here. I've just been working on the game so much that I haven't made the half an hour of time to call Comcast yet. I'm kind of dreading it, because every time it's a little bit of a issue, you know? I think, hey, that had the right height on top and bottom that time. No longer is it design res Y neither. It's letterbox height. This is also letterbox height. Some moment of inspiration right there. I don't know how I just realized those two things. Fix Comcast. Come on, Bafu. Someone in chat should be able to call Comcast, right? I know. It'd be so cool if you guys could call them for me. PMC offered that a minute ago. He's like, just call, just give me your credit card details, all your info, I'll call Comcast for you. I think that was right. Oh, I got an idea. I'll do the letterbox sprites now, but I'll keep them at only 50% opacity. So I can see through those and see if it lines up perfectly. The offer's still up. Right on, man. I wasn't quite paying attention. Oh, good, the top was perfect. Yeah. The top was perfect. Let me check the bottom. Yeah, the bottom was perfect too. Right. Awesome, awesome. So I can put these letterbox sprites back in their full opacity. It's got the right movement now. So let me kill all this code that I didn't understand. Let's get rid of all that. Now that this is right, looking good. Oh, this needs to be a spawn. Or just delay. Yeah, it'd be good to just do a delay right here. And then the other two actions can happen in their own thingy. This is flux duration. Sprite run action move by. So it's gonna move by the entire time. And then animate, same thing. But it doesn't need to specify a duration for animate. So run action, animate. There, so we're running our move by and animate in one thread or two different actions. This is fade in, out. And there's this weird scale thing. See if you get that effect to look cool. It might be neat. Almost ready to throw this thing into context, though, in the proper sequence. Cool. Only thing now is it's fade in, fade out. Let's see it at the right. I almost think these letterbox sprites needs to be faded in faster still. Yeah, it's about time to put this in context. I think I'm gonna check in what I got so far. Do I like low poly art? Yes, I do. I actually do. I love low poly art. I don't really like 3D art so much in general, but low poly art is my favorite 3D art style for sure, man. How about you? Do you like it? Yeah, I guess I can keep it like that. This is the fun branch. Okay, so the next step of today's stream is to split up the lift sword phase into two. There's lift sword begin and lift sword end. And when we do lift sword phase, it's K phase lift sword begin, K phase cutscene. K phase lift sword end, K phase zoom out, K phase item. You like lo-fi stuff? Nice. Nice, man. You're so soft on the eyes, yeah. Yeah, isn't it crazy, right? Isn't it crazy how like some like a It's like pixel art too. It's like somehow pixel art looks good even though it's so basic, right? Same thing with low poly. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's, I think it might have something to do with how low poly and pixel art, both of those force your mind to be active and imaginative. I think that's why I like them both so much. It really wakes your mind up, you know? And it's subtle and it's you know, it's a subtle visual effect. It's more like a almost an optical illusion. Don't have a final name. Oh. Poglin. So that you wouldn't get hung up on thinking of a title. Nice, man. Yeah, dude, you got the flow, dude. That's what it's about, right? You can't get hung up on little things like that. Good job. And then eventually the name comes to you and you're like, that's it. That's the name I want. Yeah, you figure it'd be easy to come up with a good name for once it's close to completion. Yeah. Okay, so the trick to this is I need to get rid of some parts of this phase. This is going to be another math-heavy moment of code here. So I'm going to have to take 15 seconds and then change it into different things and then add in the duration of this new cutscene. Make sure that everything adds up to exactly the same seconds the second time around. Hey, what's up, Peen Wally? So this is this. It looks like I need to plug this in, this new scene, right at the fifth section of this one. I think it's the fifth section of the existing lift phase. BC Warrior. Okay, so I just totally disabled the ending phase, and now I'm going to make it so each one of the that's not going to work. All right, I guess I just have to imagine. So it shoots down this vertical line at some point, and then it runs an action where it delays, and then it fades itself out and removes itself. So it needs to run this for like a split second. Is Is that right? Index 6 and 7. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is it really just 6 and 7? I don't know. Yeah, that's if they do a low poly or pixel art, right? Definitely agree. Yeah, there's an art to it. There's definitely an art to any kind of good, you know, low resolution art or low poly art. Ah, screw it. I'm just gonna take off the last one and the last one. Which means that it needs to be times 0.56 times 0.56 times 15.531. It's 8.70. Oh, and all these times are going to be broken now. Oh, man. End. Oh, no. Can't call it end. I guess final would be 0.6. So if I go this times 1 over final. I guess this could be factor. Factor equals 1 over 0.6. All this is times factor. This is a janky. I need to, you know, make this right eventually. Yeah, totally. Yeah, lots of low quality indie games out there today because of the barrier to entry. So true. Which means we need better filters, you know. Steam is a decent filter, I guess. You know, it shows us the cool games out there, right? And Steam's getting a little bit better. They're definitely better than Apple, that's for sure. Apple's discovery is so horrible. Same with Google. Any kind of mobile discovery is horrible for game developers. Okay, so I'm taking off the last two of these phases. I'm just gonna jump in and see if I can get this to work. So I don't think I want to do any of this stuff at the end of Lift Sword and there. Don't need to play the song. Don't need to find the sword. Don't need to set transient pause. I guess we should, though. This is going to be 15.531 minus 5 seconds. So this fluctuation is going to be 6.19. Fade layer hasn't changed. Okay, it doesn't need any of these first five phases. So this is I equals 0, this is I equals 1. And now we can go render dot set Z order, set local sprite dot set local Z order to render dot get Z order based on the player's current pause, which means we don't need old hero Z anymore. Get rid of old hero Z. Okay, ready to run this for the first time. I have no idea if I put all the right little mechanics in to make sure it has a lift, half of a lift. He lifts the sword halfway, basically, and then does. Let's see though. Let's see if this is even anywhere near right. I hope this isn't a bitch to sort all this out, basically, because I really had it dialed in perfectly to have him like lift the sword on the beat. The shining light comes in right on the beat and everything. So, anyways, this could take another hour or two just to get right, but. It almost did it right. Wow. Okay. The only thing it did wrong was it showed the fade layer. You're gonna go play Zelda 1, sweet! What's up, Napoki? How am I supposed to say your name? And by the way, it's once again, it's Black Screen Podcast Day. My internet connection is so horrible. It's so horrible. You can actually see it? Whoa. Yeah, you got some screenshots. Wow, cool salad dongs. This is looking great. Oh, so awesome. Are you using Unity? Is that what this is? Yeah, dude, good progress. This is so awesome. I'm trying to decide what the fade layer is supposed to be at. It's set scale, set visible, set position. I don't know, I'm gonna set it to half for now. Fade layer, set opacity, 128. Yes, Unity. Oh, yeah. Unity. Cool. Oh, it saved it. Let's get rid of the sword. Try it again. Ah, it's almost there. It's almost working. Actually wasn't too bad. Now it's timing. This is the one thing it's like, this could take forever to fix is the timing. Maybe it's supposed to be zero. And I prefer if it started this whole thing off. Or if it did it, I think it should, the player should hold over 2 hours already. All right, yeah, I should probably get going. Well, let me see one more thing. Let's see if fade layer is supposed to be at zero opacity at the end of this bit. That might be where it needs to be. Because what is the first thing it does? Sets. Let's see, it doesn't do anything with opacity. No wonder. Yeah, with saving a game, you just, you know, it depends on your platform, first of all. What platform are you on? Wait, did that look right? I guess so, it's close to right. You're doing C# Unity on Windows for now, but I want to make it multi-platform. Yeah, it already is. If you're using Unity, you're already multi-platform, man. And as far as saving your game on Unity, I don't know. I don't know how that works on Unity. It totally depends on your game, I guess. Have you looked for any tutorials on saving a game with Unity? Because I don't know exactly how Unity works with their file system. I've never really written a save game feature for Unity. I've only done the basic things like making a breakout clone and making a very simple game that didn't even need saving. So, all right, so that's it for today's stream. I'm gonna show this one more time what I'm working on, and what I'll be doing tonight. So I just got to dial in the rest of this timing for this animation. So basically what he's supposed to do is he lifts the sword up. I don't know whether I want him to do some of these light animations. Like it lights up. There's this effect around the sword and stuff. I'm not sure if I want that before the cutscene or after the cutscene. So, but I'll be fixing up all the timing for this tonight. Oh, there you go, serialize. Yeah, I gotta call Comcast. Alright, you guys, well, have a great night. Enjoy yourselves. That's it for day 307, Make It Songbringer, and I'll be back tomorrow. So, hope you guys had a good one, and have a great one.